Welcome to another lecture of wireless communication course. In this lecture, I'm going to talk about another version of input-output model for a wireless channel. I continue with that input-output model with sampling. If we want to create a channel model for discrete equivalent of that continuous time-based channel modeling, we can sample that continuous signal. We know that based on the sampling theorem, for any bandlimited signal, by sampling at a multiple integer of 1 over W, where the W is the bandwidth of the signal, we can have a discrete signals, and we can reconstruct the signals by again sampling in the receiver. So here, for doing this, we use the Nyquist transmission, which is based on Nyquist sampling theorem. It says that any sample signal can be expanded by some orthogonal signals, where the orthogonal signals here is Nyquist signals or sync signals, sync functions. So since these shift sync signals or Nyquist signals are orthogonal signals, any signals after sampling can be expressed by the linear combinations of these signals. So we have a model here that is the baseband signal is expanded by sync function or n samples. We have seen that we have n samples, so x of t is sampled at n distinct times. So these are those coefficients for that expansion, and the signal is expressed by linear combination of sync function as this. And the sync function is a well known function, is defined by sine of pi t over pi t. And some definitions, it is like this over t, but in signal processing community, the sync function is defined by the scaling factor of pi. The orthogonal basis that we use here, in these signals is a shift version of the sync function. So by sampling of these functions, these signals, and integer multiples of 1 over W, we can find the baseband output. Since we have I paths of signals, we had a relationship between output and input for multipath. So if we use that equation, which we presented in the previous lecture, we can, fusion and the shift version of x of t due to the delay reaches the function of tau. So if you use this and this and combine these two, we can get the output baseband signal. We have double summations. One is for n, the sample signal at discrete time, and one is for multipath, that is represented by r. So the first one is going to be for n. So here we have x of n. And the second one, this one is shifted so that all things that we have for here is shifted by tau. So we replace d by t minus tau. And that is a by t sinc of w. T minus W tau by T is for this and minus N. This is the summation taken over N. Now, if this signal is sampled at T equals N over W, then we can have the discrete signals for the baseband output. It is expressed here. Baseband signal, if we sample at multiple integers of 1 over w, then we have this equation. So then the y at n will be summation over n, that will be like this. Signal can be thought as a projection of this signal onto the shifted sinc function. This one. Now we have a little simplification here. Let L be the difference between A and N. Then the signal at time t will be summation will be changed to L, and this will be N minus L, and sinc of L minus tau By defining HL at time n equals summation of AI n over W B summation over n sigma L minus tau I n W multiplied by W, then this expression is simplified to y at m equals to summation of h l n x of if you compare this and this, this and this one and this one, we can find out these expressions. This one will be m minus l, because the rest of this is hl m, so this will be exactly this. So if you look at this equation, we can denote this HLM as a coefficient of a filter, so that is the filter tabs, and the channel can be interpreted as the filter, such that the coefficients gains of the channel is equivalent to the channel filter tabs. So, in a special case, if we consider that this is time invariant, always fixed, then this will be further simplified to h of L summation of A by B constant and by sinc of L minus tau I another assumption that is about time invariant property of the channel. If you assume that the delay is not a function of time, doesn't change over time, then tau I is a fixed number, depends only on the I path. So it depends on the variation of the, those coefficients corresponding to each individual path. Or we can write it in this way, that is h l equals to it's like a coefficient a or it can be expressed by look at these two, you can say that h of l is can be expressed by inclusion equation that is h b based on this and c function. Here, the F tab can be interpreted as the samples of the low pass filter baseband channel impulse response. And also, another interpretation here is about the sinc function. When we see that these signals are multiplied with some sinc functions here, of course, the convolution sum, we can interpret this sampling operation as modulation and modulation. In modulation, the baseline signal is modulated as by sinc pulse, and then upconverted to the radio frequency, and in the receiver, the sound called the signals at time M over W, and then we get the signals, and of course, path into the low pass filter, we can get the signals. Okay, now I want to mention something about sync function. In practice, sync function has a very poor time decay property. We know that the sync function goes in infinity, and the time decays in infinity. So it goes to zero at infinity. So it is not feasible to implement and realize such a signal in the communication system. Instead of this signal, we have defined calls based on this and modified version of sync function, that is, rate function. In that case, the ripples and the side loads of the sync function is clipped, and this will be removed. So by this final comment, we finish this sampling operation for creating the discrete channel. And now in the final section of this part, we want to add loops. It is very simple. We want to consider on the identified nodes that is modeled by Gaussian. Expected values of x of t or wt. Noise by WT. WT is the noise, ID by Gaussian noise. So the power spectral density of this signal is defined by multiplication of expectation of WT multiplied by the values of the signal at zero equal to n, and this function is delta function. So this means that the power spectral density of the noise is half of n. So we assume that the signal is added to the x of t minus tau again, like before, no difference here, I plus this noise equivalently in discrete domain, we have this and e. Sample signals at M over W. This will be I. Or let's say the final presentation of signals in terms of channel coefficients of HL. So here, WN is the filter, low-pass filter noise, and this time discrete domain by low pass filter. And it can be verified that this signal, in general, we assume that the signal is complex. The complex model can be found by this. It has two components. The real part can be defined by this. The signal WT multiplied with some orthogonal signals like psi and L. First one, the receiver sees the signal is a down converter. And also it is filtered out, low pass filter. This signal will be like this. These orthogonal signals have some filtering. It filters in impulse response of the filter, the sync function. That is the channel model for input-output approach. Next, we have some definitions, some terms for channels like time coherence, frequency, band coherence, and then we go to the next level, the next approach of channel modeling, which is a statistical model. Time coherence shows us how quickly channel changes in time. And the frequency coherence shows us how quickly channels change in frequency. We discussed before that when we have a single path, the delay of the channel is considered for some term like Doppler shift. So Doppler shift we define in the past as the multiplication of the carrier frequency and the time delay of that path. So let's recall that and write this again. The first Doppler shift defined as D denoted by DI also to FC tau I of T. each path has different delays. Okay? In this case, we have a new term called Doppler split. In this situation, we consider the maximum difference between the longest time delay and the shortest time delay. So here, denoted by D of S, is the maximum over all of the path if C multiplied with the absolute value of tau of time delay of I path and time delay of J path. Also, in the past we discussed about the time delay law that a single channel, a single path changes significantly. That causes the distance, so that the time requires to propagate from a valley to a peak. That was 1 over 4 di, 1 over di. For the I, that was tau of I, and in this interval, the channel is changed significantly. The tau of channel changed significantly. Now, in terms when we have multi path correspondingly, we have a term that is coherence time. Defined by tau C 1 over 4 ds. So the Doppler split is considered to calculate the coherence time. Here we have two well-known terms, this fast fading and slow fading. In case of multi-pass fading, when the delay, this delay, coherence time is very, very short relative to the delay requirements of the applications. So each application has its own requirement, delay requirements. For example, for voice communications, the delay is about 100 millimeter seconds. For data communication, is larger than this value. So here, the fast fading is happen when this time, this coherence time is much, much less than the delay of application. So the, that is the delay. And similarly, we have slow fading when the coherence time is greater than the required delay of application. So as we see here, the fading channel is not only about the characteristics of the channel, it depends on applications also.